nanti ke kuliah berapa?
Apa nama mau ke sana?
Iya.
Hah? Apa nama mau ke sana juga?
Max, Max.
Nggak, nah, iya juga.
Hah, ha, ibu dah nama tadi asyik apa?
Ibu dah nama asyik apa? Kau hendak lebih hijau ni?
Oh, cinta tapi asyik.
Tapi apa asyik?
Ah, okay. Hello students, Jai Jagannath, Ma Biraja. Welcome you all to YouTube online live classes on English organized by District Education Officer Jaipur, OSEPA, Department of School and Mass Education, Government of Odisha, Odisha. Today let us discuss an interesting topic, that is the festivals of Northeast India. We have already discussed, you have already ended. Last classes, you know that, as you all know, India is a land of fairs and festivals. People of different communities from different religions live here. They celebrate a number of festivals around the year. Festivals like Ganesh Chaturthi, Vasant Panchami, Diwali, Dasara, Rakhya Bandhan, Eid ul Fitr, Christmas, Buddha Jayanti, Mahavir Jayanti, etc. are celebrated by different communities in different regions. Good spirits and gets prosperity and they pray to goddess Mopin, and Mopin dance is famous. Mopin dance is famous, is performed in Mopin festival. And in the Manipur, in the state of Manipur, you know my children, Ningal Choko is between the married girls and their parents. That your answer, all sentences used in the answer should be grammatically acceptable. You should be careful about that. Okay, there must be sequencing or proper order or quencing. So then your answer in paragraph will be complete and accurate and appreciable. And the answer should be within 50 words as instructed by the Board of Secondary Education, Odisha. Okay, come to the next. Let us start with the question answers. You see the text first, read the first page, first paragraph of the text. The Northeast India is a collective name for the easternmost parts of India, representing both a geographic and administrative division of the country. The region comprises 8 states, namely Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Sikkim and Tripura. The contiguous 7 states, Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram and Nagaland, are commonly described as the land of 7 sisters because of their interdependence on each other. On the other hand, Sikkim is geographically not a contiguous part of the Northeast region. It is separated from the Northeast by Siliguri corridor, so it is not included in the land of 7 sisters. However, Sikkim has happily taken up the role of being a little brother to the amazing 7 sisters. This is the first paragraph. You see next, what type of question, expected question would be from this paragraph. Okay, you see the first question, you look at the map. This is the northeastern part of India and is the northeastern states of India. Geographically and from administrative ground, they are together. Like the 8 states, you see Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Meghalaya, Nagaland, Manipur, Tripura, Sikkim, and Mizoram. Sikkim is separated through from this. Why? Because it will be upon the Siliguri corridor. Question will come. What type of question? You read the question. Why are the seven states of Northeast India described as the land of seven sisters? So the, for this question, you have to think of minimum 5 points. So important key points to write your answer. The Northeast India is consisted of 8 states, contiguous except Sikkim. 7 states are touching and sharing the boundaries one another. Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland, Tripura. The land of seven sisters, interdependence or each other. These are the key points, important points. On keeping in your mind view, you have to answer in complete sentences. Question once again, why are the 7 states of Northeast India described as the land of seven sisters? The Northeast India consists of 8 states and all are contiguous except Sikkim. So the 7 states are touching and sharing the boundaries one another. Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland, Tripura are commonly described as the land of seven sisters because of their interdependence on each other. Come to the next. So let us go to one by one the festivals, the festival, important festivals of North states of Northeast India. We should discuss one after another. We read the text again and again, and we will discuss expected questions. Those are not in your textbooks. You think of that questions, and you can also get the questions from your teachers or any other sources. I have also some questions. You should write down and think of the answer and write down and get ready prepared for the forthcoming board examination. You know, Honorable Minister has already told you that you must to appear the text. So get ready. Come to the next. You see. So this is the festival of Assam. Bihu festival is the important festival of Assam. Rongali Bihu, Bongali Bihu, and Bhogali Bihu. You know, Rongali Bihu is here celebrated in Assam. Is also known as the Bohag Bihu. On the onset of spring, in mid-April, Rongali Bihu is celebrated. And in the beginning of the sowing season, you saw this is the beginning of the sowing season, and it is observed, it marks the start of the new year in Assam. That is Rongali Bihu. Come to the next, you see, Kongali Bihu. Kongali Bihu, other name is Karti Bihu, is celebrated in Assam in mid-October. When the fields are lost, green, but the barns are empty. The fields are lost green, but the barns are empty at home. People light lamps, pray to God for a growing harvest. Season and guide their souls, those are no more in their families, to heaven. And another festival, Bihu festival is it? Bhogali Bihu is also known as a Madha Bihu because it is celebrated in the month of Madha. It is observed in mid-January in Assam. The festival marks the end of the harvest season. You see, you mark the harvest is there. It is a thanksgiving occasion after the crops have been harvested and the barns are full. My dear children, you know, so these festivals are best of agriculture. Come to the next. You see, what type of question would be expected question from this? How are Bihu celebrated in Assam? If this type of question, if this question will come in the exam, you have to find out, you have to think about the key points. Bihus are among the major cultural festivals of Assam. Series of these important festivals, Rongali Bihu, Kongali Bihu and Bhogali Bihu, melodious songs and traditional dance, men and women found in their best traditional clothes. The traditional music in musical instruments as such as cymbals, bamboo, clapper, dhol and paper, all these things are their musical instruments. They are dance, traditional costume, all these things. So all these things you should keep in mind while writing the answer. So how to write the answer? In 50 words, which can 5 marks. How are the Bihus celebrated? represented in Assam. Views are among the major cultural festivals of Assam. There are a series of three prominent festivals: Rongali Bihu, Kongali Bihu, and Bhogali Bihu. Melodious songs and traditional dance always accompany the celebration of a Bihu festival. In their best traditional clothes, the traditional musical instruments such as cymbals, bamboo clappers, dhol, and bepa are favored to a Bihu dance. You see, come to the next. You see, my dear children, this is the festival of Arunachal Pradesh. You know, Arunachal Pradesh is a geographically very important and very natural scenery is there. Two important festivals of Arunachal Pradesh are there. That is Losar and another is Mopin. Losar is the major festival in Arunachal Pradesh. On this occasion, people in certain areas of state clean their homes and give up the wood to bring in New Year. New Year festival in Arunachal Pradesh. Another festival is Mopin. Mopin is the harvest festival. Gallo tribe people worship goddess Mopin and pray to drive away the evil spirits and for acquiring prosperity and wealth. An indigenous folk dance called Popiri dance is there, is performed by the young woman. Come to the question. What type of question can be for the Arunachal Pradesh? Next. You see the question. What do the people of Arunachal Pradesh do on the festive occasions of Losar and Mopin? Two important festivals of Arunachal Pradesh. So for these key points, Losar at the New Year festival celebration in Arunachal Pradesh. Clean their homes and discard the old things to bring in the New Year. Okay. Mopin is another festival, the festival of Gallo tribe. They pray to goddess Mopin to drive away evil spirits, grant prosperity and wealth. The folk dance Mopin is performed by women. So what would be the expected answer? What do the people of Arunachal Pradesh do on the festive occasions of Losar and Mopin? Losar is the New Year festival celebration in Arunachal Pradesh. People on this occasion clean their homes and discard the old things to bring in the New Year. Mopin is the festival of the Gallo tribe. The people of this tribe pray to goddess Mopin to drive away evil spirits and grant prosperity and wealth. The folk dance Mopin is performed by the women. Come to the next. You see, let us discuss very interesting festival, that is Nikal Chokova, that is Manipur. We know Manipur is another state which is famous for festivals, and it is a northeastern state. You know, in northeastern states there is heavy rainfall is there due to Brahmaputra river. The natural beauty is there, hilly area is there, full of pine trees and so. If you have chance to go there, you will never forget the beauty scenery of Manipur. So let us see the important festival of Manipur, that is Ningal Chokova and Cheruba. Ningal Chokova is a charming festival of Manipur, and this festival is held to bind and revive the relationship between married girls and their parents. And so the women and their children are given a dainty or sumptuous feast and gifts for this. And Cheruba is another festival to when they make their festive or delicious foods. Come to the next step. What type of question, expected question, can be done for this? Briefly describe Ningal Chokova and Cheruba celebrated in Manipur. Ningal Chokova first. Mani celebrated in Manipur binds and revives the relationship between married women and their parents. The women and their children are given a sumptuous feast and gifts. Cheruba is Manipur's New Year festival observed in April. Clean and decorate their houses and prepare festive dishes. Climb the nearest hill stops, have place in this life. You see, answer, expected answer. Briefly describe Ningal Chokova and Cheruba celebrated in Manipur. Ningal Chokova is an attractive festival in Manipur since it binds and revives the relationship between the married girls, women, and their parents. means every people clean and decorate their houses and prepare festive dishes. The villagers on this occasion climb the nearest hill tops with the belief, they believe that this will help them to rise to a higher place or plane in their life. If they go high hill tops, then they will have a good fortune. Come to the next. The people now, another very interesting festival is here, Wangla festival. Wangla or 100 drums festival, you see, the men are there with 100 drums. They are beating in a line and the women will say dancing. Wangla or 100 drums festival is the most important festival celebrated by the gallows of the village of Meghala. It is observed in November to mark the end of hard work, which naturally brings a good harvest. The celebration comprises beating drums, blowing horns, and traditional dancing. Love on warrior fighting and warrior skills. Now come to the next. What type of questions can be expected from this? What is a 100 drums festival? This is an important question of this chapter. How is it celebrated? 100 drums festival is Wangla. The another name is Wangla or the 100 drums festival. Celebrated by the Gerous in the villages of Meghala. It is celebrated in Meghala. Gero tribes celebrate them, and 100 drums are beaten is important point. Harvest, it is a harvest festival celebrated in November for a good harvest. Beating drums, blowing horns and traditional dancing, they do dance of men and women. Okay, what is 100 drums festival? How is it celebrated? 100 drum festival or Wangla is the most important festival celebrated by the Garud in the village of Meghala. The festival is named so because 100 drums are beaten together during the celebration. This is a harvest festival celebrated in November to mark the end of the hard work, which naturally brings a good harvest. The celebration features beating of drums, blowing horns and traditional dancing. In the dance, two parallel lines of men and women move forward together in right rhythmic manner with the beat of the drums. Come to the next step. Chapcharkut is the spring festival celebrated in Mizoram. Men and women of all ages in Mizoram wearing traditional dresses and headgears for folk dances, they sing traditional songs. And Sagadawa is an amazing Buddhist festival of Sikkim, and it is celebrated on the full moon day in Tibetan and lunar month between May and June. On this sacred day, people visit monasteries, offer prayers, water, incense sticks and water lamps. The festivities commemorates the birth, enlightenment and death of Lord Buddha. Come to the question next. What type of question can be? Describe the pomp and show which mark the celebration of Sagadawa in Sikkim. Sagadawa, important festival in Sikkim. Pomp and show is a Buddhist celebration. It is celebrated as per the Buddhist calendar. The full moon day in Tibetan lunar month between May and June. Celebrated, people visit monasteries. They do offer prayers, water, incense sticks and water lamps. The festival commemorates the birth, enlightenment and death of Lord Buddha. Come to the next. You see, this is the Karachi Puja festival of God, the 14 gods. Karachi Puja is a week-long festival of Tripura. It is marked by the animal sacrifice and worship of 14 gods as instructed by Lord Shiva. It takes place in July in old Agartala, the capital of the state. Thousands of people from Tripura to enjoy cultural programs and fairs. Come to the next. You will see the next. And what type of questions? State the importance of Karachi Puja in Tripura. Karachi Puja, week-long festival in Tripura, animal sacrifice, worshipping of 14 gods, and in Shaveri, temple having 14 deities, enjoy the cultural programs and fairs. One of India's most colorful and charming festivals in Nagaland. This festival is named after the state's most admired bird hornbill. This festival showcases the cultural heritage of 16 tribes in Nagaland. It is a 10-day long celebration where cultural dances and and sporting events are held in December every year. Men clad in cool warrior costume and show off their hunting and warrior skills. Come to the next step. You see, what are the common features of the festival observed in the North India? You can write like this. Come to the next step. Expected other questions. Come to the next other sample questions. These are the sample questions you can make. My dear children, we have less time to talk, so time is going up. So my dear children, read the text again and again and find out to try to make the questions of your own and find out the key points which should must be in the answer and write them into simple sentences, grammatically acceptable sentences, put them in order so that you can write good answers in 50 words to the questions carrying 5 marks and you will do better. Hope well, hope the best, stay at home.